would like to grab a seat, that would be wonderful.
Yes,
yeah.
I know. Yeah. You're always on the best.
Yeah. We high five and we do waves around the room.
Let's see what it sounds like.
Mural Unveiling. Today is an exciting day culminating in many, many months of dreaming and hard work. And so thank you for coming out on a holiday weekend on a Saturday morning to be in a church parking lot. I'm Bex Hayho. I have the privilege of being the director of United to End Homelessness. Wow. We created this project to use art as a driving force for good, and it is only fitting that we are here in Costa Mesa, the city of the arts, for our very first United to End Homelessness mural. Our hope is that this mural and those to follow throughout the county will engage the community in a conversation about homelessness and inspire creative thinking about long-term solutions as to how we can end our local homelessness crisis for good. Before we dive into our program, I'd like to acknowledge some of our community partners who helped make today possible. I want to thank Hannah Construction for helping prepare the wall that the mural was painted on. Thank you, Hannah Construction. I want to thank Bear Paint, who donated the paint that was used for the mural. So thank you to Bear Paint. And a huge, huge thank you to First United Methodist Church, and in particular to David Trotter, who is right over there. Thank you, David, for all your hard work. Thank you, thank you. And to Brian Peterson, to Damon Lujan, and Faces of Santa Ana for creating this incredible, inspiring mural. I can't wait for you guys to see it. I would now like to invite Costa Mesa Mayor Katrina Foley to say a few words. Mayor Foley and the City of Costa Mesa have been a great partner of United to End Homelessness since our inception, supporting our efforts and are committed to being part of positive change here in the community. Please join me in welcoming Mayor Foley.
Good morning. It's so great to be here this morning. I had the privilege this morning of walking with Sue Parks and members from the United Way around the city with our council member, Arliss Reynolds. There she is. And it was a nice, brisk walk and a great way to start our day. Welcome to Costa Mesa, the city of the arts. And, you know, it is fitting that we have this mural here. I'm going to tell you a little brief story about my connection to the Faces of Santa Ana. A couple years ago, in our family, we were helping to care for a young man whose parents were homeless and had been living in the Civic Center for many, many years. And this young man lived with us for a few years, and there was a couple of us families that helped him to try to get him graduated from high school. And as it turned out, he was one of the faces of Santa Ana, his dad rather, was one of the faces of Santa Ana that was painted by one of the students, and his face, it was in a gallery. And so that's when I first learned about this program and the amazing impact that it has on people's lives. So I'm just thrilled that we are able to have the artist here today, and we are able to have this kind of a mural here in Costa Mesa, the city of the arts. Pretty soon, Travel Costa Mesa helped to sponsor a mural that's going to be across the street. So, you know, when Shepard Ferry came here and he painted the mural that's on the Baker Block as you're heading on the 405 freeway, he hoped that it would be an impetus for creating murals all over the city of Costa Mesa. And I think he was right, and I think it's working. So I'm just thrilled to be here. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Foley. I now have the honor to introduce Assemblywoman Katie Petrinaris. She has been an unwavering force in our local fight to end homelessness and just recently secured $2.9 million in state funding for our Welcome Home OC program to help us house our homeless veterans. Please join me in welcoming Assemblywoman Katie Petrinaris.
Thank you. Good morning. Oh my goodness, it is such an honor and privilege to be here with all of you this morning. You know, the world we're living in today, this moment, it's easy to be cynical, right? It's easy. It's easy to be cynical. It's easy to feel discouraged. It's easy to get on Facebook and complain about the state of the world or fire off an angry tweet. It's easy, but it's not super productive, right? And that's why being here with all of you this morning is absolutely inspiring. Being here with the United Way, with this incredible group of community partners, and with this incredible group of community advocates and activists, you are showing us what is possible. You are showing us what's possible with determination, with commitment, with compassion, and with hard work. It is such an honor to be your partner in this effort, and I know that together we can end homelessness here in Orange County. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Assemblywoman Petrinaris. I would now like to invite Orange County United Way's President and CEO, Sue Parks, to say a few words.
Wow, thank you. It is an honor to be here. And yes, I did not go change afterwards. I did walk 3.5 miles through fabulous Costa Mesa. So all of you Costa Mesas, love it here. Thank you. And we're so excited to be here today to celebrate this amazing mural. We're going to talk a little bit more about that. But I do want to thank you so much to Mayor Foley and Assemblywoman Petrinaris for being here and for your kind remarks and setting the stage so beautifully of what's going to transpire for the rest of the morning. It is an honor, as I said, to be here, and we are also joined by some other very special guests. So in addition to Assemblywoman Katie Petrinaris and Mayor Foley, we have we have Laura Oatman, represented from Harley Ruda's office. Laura? As tall as Beck, so they work on this. Mayor Diane Dixon from Newport Beach. And Council Member Arliss Reynolds, who walked as well. City of Costa Mesa. Did I miss any electeds? Thank you all for being here. So now I do want to do a rousing thank you to all of our board members of United Way. Could you raise your hand? Just thank you, board members, for being out on the Saturday morning. We have our Vice Chair, Tam Nguyen, here. Thank you, Tam, and amazing group, many of who joined as well this morning. And has everybody that's on our United 10 Homelessness Leadership Council, could you wave your hand? We just want to thank you for your commitment and everything that you do in terms of helping us move forward with this program. So what I wanted to do is just talk a little bit about United 10 Homelessness and this initiative. We started a little bit over a year ago, and it was a vision to bring together business leaders, philanthropists, with the county and the cities, and the service providers who do the hard work every day in working with our homeless neighbors, and individuals who care, faith leaders who are inspiring so many, to bring everybody together in a room to say, let's do what's right for humanity here. Let's end homelessness together. And so it has been a privilege to be part of this journey and see what's unfolded in the last little over a year and a half. So there have been some amazing announcements. But one of the things that we've been trying to do, United End Homeless, is to bring more public awareness of who the homeless are, and they are our neighbors, and most of them have grown up here, and and something's happened in their lives and we need to help. And so bring more education to the community, bring more public awareness, which this mural project is part of, and hopefully get more people engaged in finding the solutions and the positive side and not the negative things that so often take over our lives. So we've been thrilled to be part of the public awareness, and thank you to all of you that have been part of that. Part of the other things that we've been doing is looking at special programs, and one of the reasons that I'm excited to be up here is a program called Welcome Home OC. And so we kicked that off. You just heard about the amazing gift we got to End Veterans Homeless supporting this. But this is a program that will activate the private apartment owners and property owners to get even more engaged in solving homeless. Many other communities around the country have galvanized their private apartment owners to get more involved, and we're so excited to see that happening here in Orange County. We have many that have signed up to say, I'm in, I want to help, by opening up their units to people who have a voucher. So somebody gets issued, they've been gone through the process, it's taken a long time, and they've been finally given a voucher, a federal voucher, to find a place to live. And you can imagine, you're out walking the streets trying to find something, you have this very valuable voucher that's going to provide you rent, but nobody's saying yes. And so the Welcome Homo program is designed to help property owners say yes. And so we're so excited to be able to bring that to Orange County and take away the fears and get more and more people engaged in the solution. And part of that, so we've launched that, which is off to a great start, but part of that was a request by one of the housing authorities to say, there are 30 people with vouchers. Some of them have been searching for a place to live for years, years of looking for a place to live. And so we did a short-term challenge because we have to fund the first and last month deposit and the case management and all those things to happen. And in 30 days, this community rallied together to raise $500,000 to support and get those people together. Yeah, this is the first public announcement because it was 30 by August 30, and yesterday was August 30, and we did it. Orange County, we did it. So yeah, so it's awesome. And let me tell you the leverage that this happens. These 30, by getting these 30 housed, that housing authority can go back and get prioritized to get up to 300 more vouchers to help that many more people find a home in Orange County. So I just want to thank all of you that have been involved in that and for caring, and there'll be other ways to help as we move forward. But those are some of the things that we've been working on together. And so I just want to say thank you. I want to thank all of you for being here, for being part of it, for caring, for helping us today make a big statement in this beautiful city of Costa Mesa. So we hope the mural will help more people be inspired, maybe take more journeys across our county, learn more about the people who live here. And again, we're excited to be part of that. So again, as you've heard before, together we can and we will do what? End homelessness. Thank you.
Thank you, Sue. I would now like to invite a member of our United to End Homelessness Leadership Council to come and join me and say a few words. So please join me in welcoming Charles Antis, founder and CEO of Antis Roofing and Waterproofing.
Thank you, Bex. It's an honor to be here today, and I'm really excited about today because it's an honor to serve with Sue and these amazing people on the United in Homelessness Leadership Council, because Sue's a visionary, and you just heard her up here, and she's cheerleading, and we're like going, yes, yes, we're ready to go to the next stage. And then about a year and a half ago, Sue talked about this idea, this concept that we would find some awesome partner in the community, and that we would come unveil this work that would allow people to pause, just to pause and reconsider their bias and what they thought, what homeless people were, why they were homeless, or just to get us to pause. And today, I'm so excited because we have that pause, and I have the advantage, thank you, Bex, of getting a sneak peek of what Brian and the other artist, I'm sorry I didn't get your name, you guys, what you created is so beautiful, because we're gonna have exactly what you dreamed about a year and a half ago, what I put in my head that I was racing, when am I gonna do the murals, I would say. Well, I wanna do the murals, and finally it's here. And I have to say also that I had the pleasure of meeting Sarah and David before the leaders of this congregation, and they just said everything right for me, because they said, they talked about the community and they talked about how it's their job to build the bridge all the way to everyone in the community. And that's what I believe. Being the founder and CEO of Antis Roofing and Waterproofing, I could never let anybody have a leaky roof just because they didn't have the money to pay. And so when I ran across this concern in our community, because I avoided it, I pretend it wasn't there. I did. I just avoided it. It didn't enter my conscious mind, but once it did, I was so glad that you were here, that all of you were here, and it feels like family to be here. You know, I run into people like Tam that I see at other places, and we believe it's our job, just like this congregation, to build the bridge all the way to everybody, no matter what. And if you are a senior VP or a CEO of a company, I'm asking you to come. Because if not you, then who? Thank you.
Thank you, Charles. Up next, please join me in welcoming the Reverend Sarah Heath of First United Methodist Church.
Thank you so much for being here, for being in our parking lot. As some of you know, we had buildings in this space up to about 4 years ago, and they brought those down in order to make space. We talk about how we have been rooted in this community. This church started in 1912 is when they first started, and they really believed in being part of the community. This building was started to be built in 1927 and finished in 1928. But something happened that was mentioned earlier where it began to be invisible, even though it had been something that had sort of been this uniting force for the community. People just saw this building. Many people today told me, I thought this building was closed. Well, it wasn't. It was still a community of people who were trying to love their community the best they could. What's interesting is all the buildings around here look a lot like this building because it mirrored what was created here. Our hope and our connection here is that we're really lucky. We kind of have always had a heart for art. If you get a chance, go inside the church, you'll see they built their own stained glass windows. Community members made those. Art has always been part of the heart of this community. And so for us, as we looked at this building, which by the way has AT&T products in it, when we looked inside this building, we wanted to do something with it other than just have this building here. And so we were gonna do a mural project. And here is sometimes how I think the divine works. Bex and I were just as friends talking about it, and I said, hey, my friend I think is gonna come and do a mural. And she said, don't, what if we? And I was like, oh, that sounds great. And United Way and United to End Homelessness have been a big part of my life. United Way is a big deal in my family. My parents are grand givers in the state they live in. So I knew and believed in this organization. Bex had come and given a class to all of our people and really taught us some of the things we assumed about our neighbors that we were trying to love so well were wrong. And maybe even some of the ways we were trying to help were actually harming. And so it was great for us to say, can we do something? She said, yes, you can. Give us a wall. And we decided, okay, and we started talking about it. And then the fun thing was getting to be in that creative room and again, how God kind of shows up in some interesting ways. We said, do you know what that building looks like? And all of us at the same time, you'll see what we thought it looked like. And you're gonna agree. What's happening here, we hope, is what happened so many years ago, that the rest of the businesses around here will start to mirror what the heart of the church community is. And that is, we are a people who are indeed made to bridge the gap for folks, to welcome people in who feel like they haven't had a home in a long time. That is kind of our message here. We always say, you are already loved by God. This is already your home. We just want to invite you here. And so I'm really grateful to Bex for letting us do this and have fun with this. I'm really grateful to, we have congregation members who have been here since they were kids, and for them trusting us in this process. Don't worry, you're going to love it. Maybe. I don't know. I feel like maybe. So we're excited about that. But I want to introduce you to someone. We have a director. She is the district assistant. She does all kinds of incredible things for us. This is Reverend Paige Eves. And she wanted to share a little bit from our denomination, which is United Methodism. So here she is.
Indeed, a few years ago, we tore all the buildings down. We invited Pastor Sarah and we said, hey, could you do more with less? Be creative, we said. Innovate, we said. And indeed, she has begun to talk to new people and make new partners. I would say that United to End Homelessness is a natural partner for the United Methodist Church. Across our district, across our connection, we're engaged fully in ending homelessness. We are sending thousands of dollars and hundreds of hours of volunteer time to organizations like Families Forward that help get families transition into homes. We are leveraging our underutilized land to provide affordable housing. We're on target just in Orange County and San Diego to add 400 units of affordable housing in the next few years. And some of our churches near the border have rehabbed their facilities on the inside to provide emergency shelter for people coming across the border and for refugees. So our churches remain fully engaged in the goal of ending homelessness. I would say, you know, if the mural were on the inside, then it would serve to continue to inspire church people to stay engaged. And we do hope maybe sometime you might venture inside on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. for engaging worship in a word that's relevant to your life. But because the mural is on the outside, it's here to remind all of us of our public and shared accountability to our homeless neighbors. And thank you, Sarah, for providing that wall and for being this place. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Heath and Reverend Eves. And thank you again for providing this site for our first ever mural. It is now my pleasure to introduce you to the artist who brought, well, one of the two artists who brought this mural to life. Please join me in welcoming Brian Peterson, artist and founder of Faces of Santa Ana.
Good morning. Thank you to United to End Homelessness and First United Methodist Church for just this partnership. It's been amazing. But for me, 4 years ago, I embarked on this journey to get to know my neighbors. And I'm an artist, so I began to paint portraits of all of my neighbors in Santa Ana experiencing homelessness. So the title immediately of homelessness became very personal to me. So I wasn't just United to End Homelessness, I was united to help and find housing and solutions for Ben and Cindy and Bo and Kim and Matt. They became friends to me. So I'm much more than an advocate, I believe. I'm a friend to the lost, a friend to the broken, a friend to the hurting and invisible. And so over the last 4 years, we've painted 36 portraits. Many of them have already sold and been able to help people in ways we could never imagine. But in doing so, I get to be connected to so many organizations, many of which are here today. CDP, New Song Church, Mercy House, United to End Homelessness, First Methodist. And it's been this amazing journey connecting with people in our county that care, people in our county that want to see change. And so when this mural project came up, it was the most unique experience we've ever had because we had to design a mural that not only embodied what we believe, but also caught the vision of what ending homelessness looks like. Caught the vision of the housing first model placed around us to see people housed and then services come to them. And so we sat at this table, as Sarah mentioned, as creatives, sort of thinking and bouncing ideas off of each other. And we walked away with what would it look like to have a mural that had a question and an answer. And so as we reveal this wall, be prepared to read the question and then see the answer to what we believe will change the lives of the people that feel the most invisible. And so I just want to thank Damon Lujan. Damon, stand up. I know you're recording, but stand up. So every mural Faces of Santa Ana has ever installed has been with Damon Lujan. He actually taught me how to do murals. And we also, a guy who can't be here, his name is Ned McGown. And Ned is actually experiencing homelessness, and we brought him on board to help us to install this mural. So as you can imagine, this was very personal to Ned, but he has a passion for art and creativity. So we believe in involving our friends and everything that's happening through the organizations and the cities around us. And I just want to thank you all for being here. I'd love to meet you all. Please introduce yourself after this. And I just want to thank all of you involved for making this possible.
Thank you, Brian. We have now reached the time in our program where we'll present special certificates to each of the individuals and organizations that made today's unveiling possible. I'd like to welcome, we're not going to fit on stage, so I would like to welcome in front of the stage, Mayor Katrina Foley, Assemblywoman Cadi Petrinaris, as well as Laura Oatman, District Director from the office of Congressman Harley Reuter's office. Each of you, perfect. We're gonna go rogue here. This may work, it may not. Okay, I'm unwrapping this mic. Perfect. I will do this.
I'll go first. Okay. Okay, so I am just thrilled. And I wanted to first acknowledge Brian. I'm going to bring you back up here. And maybe what we can do is we can all share in giving the certificate and say a few words about Brian from each of us and then move to the next person. Does that work, ladies? Okay, perfect. Okay, Brian, come on over here. So right here, next to us. So I'm going to read this because all of these certificates say the same thing, but I want to say a few words after that. In recognition of the unveiling of the first United to End Homelessness mural in Orange County, thoughtfully created by Brian Peterson and Damon Lewin, renowned artists of Faces of Santa Ana, we are honored that you have partnered with First United Methodist in Costa Mesa, where the piece will be proudly displayed, inviting community to engage and think creatively about solutions for homelessness. And I wanted to thank United Way also and for bringing this mural here. And I want to thank you for painting Daryl's face in Santa Ana. Daryl struggles, and he's still homeless, but he's somebody who I care about, and he was literally crying when he showed me. He was so proud to show me that mural that you painted, or one of your students painted for him. So thank you, Brian.
Thank you. Once again, on behalf of the California State Assembly, it really is an honor to be here with all of you today. And it is an honor and privilege to meet you, Brian, and to be able to give you this certificate to thank you for your inspiration, to thank you for bringing your gift and your passion to helping us solve homelessness and end homelessness here in Orange County. Thank you.
All right. We're gonna have to go.
Here we go. Come on over. All right. Brian, it was such a pleasure to meet you this morning and to meet your wonderful mother. Where is she? Let's have her stand up. Welcome. What's mom's name again?
Kendall.
Kendall, welcome to Orange County. We love you, and we're so proud of your son. He has brought such a gift to our community, so thank you so much. And Brian, I would like to present you this certificate of special congressional recognition presented to Brian Peterson in recognition of creating a piece of art that asks our community to think creatively about solutions for homelessness throughout Orange County. So congratulations, Brian. Thank you so much. I hope you have room on your wall for all this, huh?
I'm just going to call up Damon Lujan, and Damon, come on up. We want to also just recognize you and present you with the certificate. I think we all have one for you. Why don't you stand in the middle here? Thank you for your vision and all you're doing in Orange County.
Thank you, sir.
The next folks we'd like to recognize are our hosts. Our host for this morning and our host for this incredible art. The First United Methodist Church. I loved hearing your remarks. I love that the pastor of this incredible church is this dynamic young woman. I love it. But thank you for creating a place in the community where we can come together and where people can help be part of the solution. Thank you so much.
Girl power.
Okay, and then we have one more, and I'm going to take a moment, and I'd like to ask Bex to come up here, and Sue, come on up. And this is a certificate for the United to End Homelessness effort, and I want to thank you all for all of the hundreds of hours that you're putting into our community to educate people about the importance of addressing this issue. And I want to thank you for giving us in Costa Mesa, and I'd like to, is Arliss still here? Arliss, come on up here. Come share this with us. and I want to, you know, Arliss and I, you gave us the space to be able to get out into our community and to have the courage to do something to end homelessness. And Michelle, come up here too. I want you to get up here because you were part of that effort. And you all helped us. You educated us. You helped us to speak language that people could appreciate and understand. And you gave us some tools so that we could go out into our community and gather support so we could open a homeless shelter here in Costa Mesa on April 5th. And we've since had more than 70 people come through our shelter, and we've permanently housed 14 individuals. Okay, this is decades of people closing their eyes and not paying attention. People ignoring and hoping that someone might move on to another city, or maybe they would just go to another block or another park. And we decided to go all in. We are in. Are you in? We're in. And we're in Costa Mesa, and we're going to continue that. And we are opening a permanent shelter by the airport. We've spent $10 million of our own taxpayer money to end homelessness. And so we appreciate the partnership, and this is in recognition for that wonderful partnership. So thank you.
I believe that the lovely Sue Parks is coming to join me.
Yeah. So before we get to the main event, so thank you so much for being here. We so appreciate the passion, the energy, the positivity that's coming from this group. And again, thank you. And today is the start of this journey, of the mural journey. And so tell your friends, be sure to spread the word. I'll Bex tell you how.
I will gladly tell everybody how, Sue. You can help us spread awareness While you're here today, we encourage you to take as many photos as you would like with the mural, post it on your social media, and use the hashtag, you ready for it?
Yeah.
Hashtag United Murals OC.
Okay, got it.
United Murals OC. And invite your friends to come and check it out. We also have a text to join number. If you haven't joined our campaign yet, we encourage you to text the number that's on the back of our shirts and join our campaign and get involved with this movement to end homelessness. There's power in conversation. It can spark change and positive impact. Thank you for all being a part of the movement.
All right, so thank you again. This is gonna be exciting. So now, before we unveil, we need everybody to turn this way, and David is gonna take a group shot. So everybody face the triangle. And David, where are you? Right there. So David's our amazing photographer. What, face David. David, raise your hand, kind of thing. Everybody looking? Okay, everybody face David. If you're behind David, please get in front of David, kind of thing. But we want you all looking towards David. Everybody. Keep everybody looking towards David. He needs more. Everybody smile. Smile. Say, together we can and we will end homelessness.
Together we can and we will end homelessness.
Yeah. Okay, so now.
Stay there. Stay where you are. Stay where you are. Charlene, I see you peeking. Stay where you are. While we're staying where we are, I'm going to encourage you to check out Toast, who helped provide our awesome food and coffee. If you haven't been to that restaurant yet, it's in Costa Mesa.
And I want to also say thank you to all the United Way staff and Bex, who's been leading this team. Let's have a round of applause for Bex and the team. Everyone, thank you. There's a card with all the information, with the hashtags and all those kind of information. And if we stall long enough,
as we count down, when we reach one, you may turn around. Okay, so 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, turn! Woo! Okay, thank you everyone. Let's explore the mural.
Thank you.